Hey guys, how's it going? Octopus here, welcome back to Union Cross. We're gonna be talking about the new medal that just hit JP. It is Prime HD King Mickey, and this medal looks amazing. So it is the first tier 7 prime medal to hit the game, and I don't think it's gonna be the last for sure, but I don't think any more tier 7s are gonna come along with it. I think this is something special because Prime HD Mickey is only here for his celebration, the birthday, obviously, and after this banner is gone, he's not coming back, unless they do something way down the line on the next birthday. But it is a limited time medal, so this is the only chance to get it. It will not be in any other banner until further notice. So I think that they're bringing out tier 7s first before tier 6s, just because of Mickey's birthday. But once this is gone and we head into the next couple of banners, I'm pretty sure we're gonna start into tier 6 primes, or maybe they just might skip tier 6 altogether and go right to tier 7. Who knows? Let me know what you think about that down below. I just thought it was interesting that they jumped right to tier 7, but that's just my idea that they're just going to do this for King Mickey, and then they're going to start tier 6s. So a little sneak peek of what's to come for tier 7s. So what does Mickey do? Prime HD Mickey is a two-turn, deals 4 hits. The buffs that gives it to the player is 7 power strength up, 3 upright strength. For defense down on the enemy, he gives general defense, power defense, upright defense, and reverse defense all down by 7. And he also increases every medal's after his cast up to 120% guilt. So extra 120% on top of everyone for himself and afterwards. So he's got a great set of debuffs. He's got everything except for magic and speed. It's just like every other prime medal, they take care of their own attributes. Mickey is an upright power medal. He does deal more damage though, the higher the slot number. So that means that 120% is a little bit awkward when you look at that. So if you really need that 120% for that keyblade you're using specifically, you're gonna have to put him somewhere closer to the beginning, and that's an issue. I'm gonna explain why. Because it drops down to a 26.88 in power instead of the 31.17 AoE metal that he is. So it's really good damage for being an AoE metal. It's just that when you're playing with this 120%, you kind of want to put him at the end of the keyblade for max damage, but if you do, none of your medals get that 120, so that's kind of scary. But he's also got next medal attacks with power attributes, so he changes the next medal into a power medal, like Timeless River Sora changes the next medal into a speed medal. So right here, guys, is a combination of basically the foretellers mixed with the stained glass medals, just missing a couple of buffs. He doesn't have any general strength up, he doesn't fully max out your upright strength, and he doesn't apply the reverse strength either. So he's missing a little bit when you compare him to, let's say, what I got right now, Stained Glass Terra. Stained Glass Terra, 2 turns, he does that 7 power, but he got that 7 upright and 7 reverse strength upwards. And you can see everything else over here is just like Mickey, but he's got 10% less. But this Terra has to be at the beginning of a keyblade, which you do want him there at a 32.50 max multiplier, or 29 for a smaller one. But this is a tier 8, you can't really compare it. So it's like just a little bit of a downgraded version of these medals, missing a couple of buffs, missing a little bit of strength when it comes to the max multiplier, just not fully there, but does not mean it's bad. As you compare it to everything else in the game, when you look at it, there's actually quite a bit of medals ahead of it, but you can't count max multiplier versus the foretellers or the birth by sleep trio, because they got AoE multiplier of 27.54, where the foretellers got a multiplier of 25.44, Sora and Kairi's got a multiplier of 28, so that 31 multiplier is a lot better. But you can see that there is a couple medals ahead of them. In JP version, you have this guy right here, 31.28. You've got yourself Axel over here at a 31.28 as well, and so on. You can see 31s, 32s, but you're comparing tier 7 to a tier 8. Tier 7 prime medal are usually better than any other prime medal in the game. So let's change that to tier 7 and look at where he sits. So like I said, he sits right over here. Usually prime medals are the best of the best, and he is, because when you look at these guys' AoE multiplier, the best one is 28 over here. Mickey's got that 31, but he's got to be at the end, and you only lose on that 120. So if you don't care about that 120, you're gonna have a great AoE medal at 31. But when you compare it to the other tier 7s, it's about a 2 multiplier difference, which is big in damage. That can be the make or break in a lot of missions. But like I said, it is the best AoE medal in the tier 7s. That's what prime medals are supposed to be, the prime of that tier. So the problem I have with Mickey, and why you guys might skip on it, there's a lot of ups, but there's also downs on every medal, is that he doesn't ignore enemies' counters. So you're gonna hit those blue counters, you're gonna hit those red counters, and he's gonna trigger something like the Marluxia event going on right now. He deals 4 hits, and all those enemies have blue counters, and if you actually attack this guy, if you just attack once or try to copy him, those counters are gone. He does not ignore counters. So we need more medals that buff us and also increase counters to make him more effective. But currently right now, unless you buy VIP or you pulled for the new nominee EX Kai, you're not going to really have the ability to start doing 4 hits on enemies. It's not that high, but when it comes to prime medals have that ability of skipping. At least the tier 5 prime medals have that ability of skipping the enemy's counters, not affecting them at all. Where this guy actually affects those counters. So that's the little downfall I have with them. When you guys are like, oh, well, he's not really good compared to Stained Glass and Foretellers. Those medals were 30,000 jewels. You're comparing a 30,000 jewel medal with a 3,000 jewel. Because the banner in JP, this medal is guaranteed every single pull as a 6-star. And if you pull 5 times, you get him as a 7-star. So you're comparing something expensive to something at the regular price of 3,000 jewels. So definitely a good buy if you don't have any of those Stained Glass Foretellers. If you guys don't have your own Sephiroth, Supernova, Keyart 19, this guy is amazing for that. Great AoE multiplier. Got all these buffs that in PvP he will be carrying over. So all these debuffs will carry over unless the opponent takes care of them. You're going to be affecting 2 Keyblade setups with this, and you're also going to get 120% on the second Keyblade. Again, if you ignore this 120%, there's nothing really wrong with this multiplier. You want to put them near the end of the Keyblade. When it comes to buffs and debuffs, if you want him to start off with another medal that gives times 7 general strength, then of course he's got to be in the beginning. But realistically, he can just be there somewhere. And in my opinion, if I didn't already have a Cloud, tier 5 Cloud, I would be using this Mickey instead, because I'm using my prime clouds right now with a defense boost 4 max, defense boost 6 to complement other Keyblades when Terra carries over his buffs. So this would be a candidate for defense boost 4 max if he had that general strength, but you can still put a defense boost 6 on him or 4 max for the next Keyblade or something like that. He doesn't have to be your attacking metal. He could be that defensive metal that has those buffs that carry over and so on, like I do with my Stained Glass Terra. It's just that you're missing that general strength, so it's not really there, but that is an option for anyone looking at PvP wise. But again, when you look at tier 7s, he is the best of the best when it comes to AoE multiplier, just by a little bit. If you guys did pull this or the Sora, they have to be on the 3rd slot, 5th slot. He's got to be somewhere in the 5th slot to do maximum damage. Pet slot for Leon for that 29, or high score challenge medals at 29. Besides that, you start dipping into the 28s, and then 27s, and 26. And I want to mention Pete here, because 26.82, if he's in the higher slot, is Mickey's weakest point. That's 26.88. if he's in the beginning of a Keyblade. So still not that bad, but when you compare his low end multiplier to like these guys here, they're gonna do way more damage. It's just that he has all these buffs and debuffs. But again, Kairi Kai, Shion Kai, Stained Glass Medals, Foretellers, if you have those in your setups already, none of this matters unless you're doing PvP for the multiple turns, because during that Keyblade, he's going to have maximum strength anyway, so you are going to put him near that 31 at the end of the Keyblade. So you lose that 120. There's a little bit things in here and there, but when you really look at the medal itself, it outshines a lot of your tier 7s, just not by much. He doesn't have ignore any of his counters, which kind of hurts, but he is limited, and if he's guaranteed every time you pull, then pull once, grab him, limited medal, throw those 7-star fairies in there, put them on them, and you got yourself a 7-star tier 7 that does a lot of damage. You just gotta make sure you're not attacking anyone with blue counters. When you do compare him to tier 8s though, I know it's like not really fair, but just to show where he sits and really talk about why he's good, you look at Sephiroth, Keyart 19, and Riku, their AoE multiplier is a 31.48, and you've seen the power that comes out of these medals. they have a lot of damage. And Mickey being a prime metal, he can sit with an extra 1,000 chips, meaning he's got 2,000 chips total attack. Sorry, 2,000 attack total because of chips, where these metals can only hold 1,000. So that's another thing you want to consider, is that you get an extra, basically you rolled plus 1,000 attack for traits. So when you compare these guys' damage for AoE, that Mickey is not that bad. Not the raid. Let me put tier 7 again to show you guys. So Mickey versus tier 7, tier 8, 31.17 versus that Sephiroth's 31.48. Not far off at all. I also want to point out another thing about the whole Mickey versus the Sephiroth, the Riku, and the KR19, is that when you look at the base multiplier of 10.39, and you look at Sephiroth's base multiplier for the AoE at 9.54, when you start adding that 120% guilt boost into Mickey versus Sephiroth, Sephiroth's max AoE damage is 42.93, but Mickey's max damage is 43.64. So the more this 120%, 130%, 140%, 50 gets increased by our buffers or attacking metals, even right now, this metal is going to be a lot better than other AoE metals just by his base multiplier of 10.39. So when you look at it that way, this Mickey is very powerful for AoE damage, especially when he applies his own 120% and you versus 120% on other metals. Base multiplier makes that increase of 120 just that much better, and he starts surpassing other metals in the game because of that. So back at the tier 8s only, you look at the best AoE medals or their high score challenge medals, 36.40. They have to be basically at the end of the Keyblade because they deal more damage the more gauges used, but they got a max multiplier of 36. So that is a lot of damage. And then you do got Foretellers who are at 34.15 with they have higher HP. So they are stronger, but again, they are tier 8 compared to a tier 7. But just in case you already have medals like this, you really don't need the Mickey, just for collection for the 3,000 jewels. And then you look at tier 8, basically bottom of the line, 32 multipliers on almost everything, especially if you guys were one of the people that pulled key art 16, you got a good AoE medal at 32.41 already, stronger AoE. But it all depends if you're new, if you're a veteran. You guys can basically skip on the Mercy pull, but I wouldn't skip on the one guaranteed pull, because he has his place, especially in PvP. He does have his place, but it's nothing spectacular. But he does got some new animation going on, which is pretty cool. So it's nice to see that they're starting to do some new animation. It might just because it's Mickey, it's his birthday. So they give him a special medal altogether. Sneak preview to tier 7. Here's a new animation. We're working on stuff. So pretty cool to see. But it's all up to you guys what you want to do with it. This is what I'm going to compare it to. Everything that's going on, when you get the medal and you put attack boost 7 or 8 max on it, it's going to do a lot of damage. You just got to look at what it doesn't offer and where it's got to sit. Because remember, upright power, let me just look at a couple keyblades right now. You got to put this guy near the 5th slot. I'm pretty sure it's the 5th slot to do maximum damage. So let's look at the treasure trove. Treasure trove, you got reverse power over here. So he has to sit on the slot before, which is the 4th slot. You look at Starlight. Starlight doesn't have an upright power. You look at Olympia. Again, 4th slot. Then you got to go look at Moogle of Glory. 5th slot. So it works on the 5th slot for Moogle Glory, but at a level 35, Moogle Glory is only at 2.20. Then you got to go look down at Stroke of Midnight. Stroke of Midnight, 1st slot only, so you're using that for that 2-turn setup I was talking about. If you already have General Strength carrying over from the previous Keyblade, he can sit right there and do a ton of damage and buff upright, reverse, and all that for you for enemies' defense down. Not buff, but debuff. Then you got Fenrir. He does fit really nice on the 5th slot on the Fenrir. And then you got yourself Darkgnaw, which he doesn't fit over there. And basically Fairy Stars, again, in the 1st slot. So obviously he can fit in the Spear slot, but usually Spear slot, you want to put your most powerful single target metal there when it comes to PvP. In PvE, if there's a lot of AoE groups, then of course you're going to put an AoE metal over here. But just to show you guys the Keyblades that he sits on, to give you guys a better understanding where he might be sitting. He is going to compete with your Cloud that you guys pulled for Sephiroth. So if we look at tier 5 prime metals for 7 star, we're going to look at Cloud real quick, and you got your prime Cloud here with an AoE multiplier of 23.85. so It's a big difference. If you guys have Clouds and he's been helping you pass a lot of stuff, or even the Roxas, you know how much damage these AoE medals do at 23. The thing is, they ignore enemies' counters, and when there's only one enemy left, they start dishing out 35.90, which is a lot more than 31 point something. So, you just gotta keep in consideration, what upright power medals do you guys already have that are taking up those slots? Is it worth changing? Do you guys already have like a Hercules extra attack? Do you already have your own Sora and Kairi doing 28 multiplier? It's not as strong, but it definitely, you got to keep that in consideration. Do you have your own Foretellers? Do you have a Stained Glass medal? 27.85, it's on the fifth slot. So on and so on. You guys got to look at that. Did you guys pull Kingdom Hearts 2 Cloud? And did you make him a 7-star? He's got a 32.41. So it's all up to you guys in the end. But my end result of Mickey, I'm going to pull once. Me personally, for my two accounts, going to pull once. He is 120 pet points, might even pull twice to get that extra 144 points. Better than Maleficent, better than the Jack medal, better than the Halloween Town Sora medal. All of those were worth 144 pet points, but they were all bait, because now you can see everything is getting 120 points or 144 as you go down. So it's all with patience, and that's how my free-to-play account collects all those jewels, because I always see those comments, how does a free-to-play account have so many jewels? You skip out on the bad banners that don't really give you anything. But yeah, limited time medal. Let me know what you guys are doing with your account. Are you going to pull for it? Are you going to skip for it? Is it going to help you? Every account is different, guys. So make sure that you look at what you already have, what Keyblades the medal can sit on, and if it's going to really improve your game. If it's not going to, then skip it. Save those jewels for the next banner. That's going to really help you out. If you guys did enjoy the video, though, don't forget to hit the like button. And as always, thank you so much for watching. Keep on smiling, and I'll see you in the next one.